before I shacked up with the Aesir, aye. Another of my spectacular failures.
In capturing these spirits, you seek redemption.
I just want to send these bloody monsters to hell where they belong. Wouldn't exactly call it redemption, but I know I'll feel better once it's over.
I hope we see each other again.
And under different circumstances, one hopes.
Now that he's safe, we may leave. But it seems there's much to be done in this crater if you wish to explore.
Another cue.
It's a sign we're on the right trail.
There's danger ahead. Soul Eaters may look just like rocks, but are far more deadly.
Stay alert.
Aye. Some rocks are not like the others.
Steel yourselves.
Now, life in this valley can flourish again.
I hope so. Vanaheim has suffered enough.
It will prove resilient.
How are you so sure?
wastelands tend to reflect the ones who care for it most.
Was that a compliment?
I heard it too.
So let me see if I understand. We're expected to find someone to relieve Hrasfelgr and become Hell? Not exactly an office many would wish to occupy.
Aye. Terrible weather, infinite hours, and the possibility of unleashing terrible mischief on the realms if they're careless. Ah, but enough of that for now. Right side, brother!
You're on fire, Kratos! It will pass!
Left side! Incoming!
Freya, when Hildisvini went to Helheim, how did he not freeze to death?
A perk of the Jofur.
The boar-shifting warriors of Vanaheim. As wise in statecraft as they are deadly on the battle...
So they may shift into whatever form they like.
Sure. So long as the only two shapes they'd like to shift into are human and boar.
So, how worried should we be, Mimir, about the Hrasfelgr situation?
Oh, it'll be trouble for all of us if the position is filled by someone unfit. Or worse, if they aren't completely trustworthy.
But if she were to leave without a replacement?
Complete chaos, yes.
Well, I'm sorry I asked.
More say that.
Those blades, will ya? I'm not
Yet another mystery crystal.
Hell of a job you did at Ragnarok, General. Wish I could have been there to see you and Sindri take down Thor and Odin.
That is not what happened.
Yeah, maybe not, but it's the story I like best. Important thing is, Odin's paid in full for what he did to Brock. I know it doesn't fix what's broke, but it ain't nothing. Things are getting hotter. Oh, what can I do for a god?
Impressive.
What do you need, handsome? Go show it off.
Free from their suffering.
Hmm.
I believe that's the last of them.
And that's the last of them. Spectacular work, I guess. Not that I care. You mean nothing to me. Nothing at all.
That's great, friend.
You're not my friend. Goodbye. I love you.
Good gracious.
We will stop it.
Maybe you can ignite it with your blades. It shouldn't harm the creature. The wisp protects that which it feeds on. Look, over there. There's a metal plate here with glowing runes. For what it's worth.
Now what could that mean? Brother, what you said before about the oracles of your land being fooled by their own prophecies, I get the sense that was coming from personal experience, eh?
Yes, but we will speak of this later.
Remember which god raised her dander up.
It does not matter.
Doesn't it?
If rage is all that remains, her reasons are irrelevant.
Brother, what you said before about the oracles of your lands being fooled by their own prophecies, I get the sense that was coming from personal experience, aye?
Yes. Once, I sought the oracle for a means to break my bondage to Ares. One priestess had visions that showed her Olympus would be brought to ruin by the god of war. Therefore, she helped me, intending to undermine Ares and protect her realm. She did not foresee that I would kill him and take his office in the end. I proved her vision of doom correct.
So the Oracle herself brought about the very future she hoped to avoid. I'm so very relieved we didn't do the same. Another one of those mysterious crystals. Preferable to silence at last? A rare day. I'm touched. But since you mention it, there has been one on my mind of late. It goes back to my earliest day. When I had little more to do than observe the mortals who passed through our forest. One summer, a local laird of renowned eccentricity chose to sequester himself with a small coterie of kinsmen and followers. The aim of their woodland retreat was to achieve enlightenment through study and discipline. They took oaths to brook no distractions until they became wise men.
Distractions?
Aye. Women. Drink. Mostly women. As you can imagine, things deteriorated quickly. By autumn, tempers were frayed and wisdom remained in short supply. One day, I watched as the laird and his brother took their hunt. There they found, at the banks of a river, a lady as fair as any they'd left behind. She pleads for their assistance for fear the currents would carry her off if she tried to cross. The laird doesn't miss a beat. He hoists her onto his shoulders, carries her across, sets her down, doffs his cap, and fords back across to his brother, who is dumbfounded, can't even bring himself to speak. The day stretches on, the laird carries on hunting. And his brother quietly gnashes his teeth down to powder.
No more for now. Focus.
Needs your help coaxing this stag back to the world tree. The boss needs your help, mind you. Not me. I'm doing great. Got a belly full of stag feed. Living life, but yeah. Talk to him back at the round between realms when you got a moment.
A stag of winter. It looks hungry.
Come on already! Just come back with me! I don't care how hungry you are.
I might finish my story from before. The Laird had abruptly broken his oath by carrying the maiden across the river, and his brother spent the afternoon biting his tongue in confusion and simmering outrage. Finally, the dam breaks. "Brother," he cries, "how could you do it after everything we've sacrificed? How could you break your vow like it was nothing, carrying that lass on your shoulders like you were a Shetland pony?" The Laird just smiled. "Brother, I sent that last line across the river. You carries a still." Oh, I got a chuckle. A rare day indeed. Ah, another crystal. Best hold on to it until we can figure out what to do with it.
Over there. We could beach the boat. Look up. our dragon staff.
We will find a way up.
There. That's where the dragon will have built its nest.
This way.
Oh dear.
Push forward.
Another problem to the left.
Question first, brother. You wanted to make this valley your home. What stopped you?
I remember. This valley, it was on the brink of devastation when I found it.
Was it a crater like you see now?
No, but the town was in shambles. Shattered glass, things. There was no hope to be made here.
Did you see what caused the destruction?
I remember walking into a meat hall, and Thor was there.
What was he doing in the meat hall?
There were whispers. He was looking for a Vanir military outpost. I didn't want any trouble, so I got out quick. That's the last I saw of him. But maybe there are others who saw more.
I wonder if Thor was meeting someone at the meat hall.
Faye and Thor sharing a drink?
Faye never drank with me. And she would not have with him.
Sometimes we never really know the ones we love, brother. She's back for more.
She certainly is relentless.
I know who this huntress is, brother. The Aesir called up. The Untamed Fury.
Must have been after my time.
Vanir refugees, families, hid in this jungle to escape the Aesir. Einherjar Yar searched, but it was the Untamed Fury who found them, picking them off night after night, until they were all dead.
They chose the wrong jungle, and her retreat is strategic. Prepare yourself.
Eyes up!
Got him!
Behind you, Kratos!
This one's done. Got a ways to go before this crater's cleared out.
Another raven freed.
Mm-hmm.